That's it. That's all we know about Metroid Prime 4. Doesn't mean we can't speculate a little bit, though. We all know at this point that Silex, a bounty hunter that we fight in Metroid Prime Hunters, will be the main villain of Metroid Prime 4. How do we know? He's shown up at the end of the two latest games in the Prime series, so it's not going to be a surprise when he's the antagonist. Is this a good thing for Nintendo to do? Well, it wouldn't make sense to bring back Dark Samus since she's, well, you know, dead. No, she's not coming back. We've had no new antagonists since the start of the Prime series, so it'd be good to see a new face. We've had Ridley, Dark Samus, and these bastards. Anyway, Silex is arguably the second most popular bounty hunter in the Metroid series. No need to explain who the first is. So Silex has that going for him, not to mention that his story could sow the seeds for the events that unfold in the main series, in terms of what the Federation planned to do with the Metroids, one of which Silex now possesses as we see at the end of Federation Force. How did he get it? He infiltrated a Galactic Federation base, of course. Even before the events of Samus Returns, it turns out the Federation were corrupt. Anyway, back to Silex. With his newfound pet, he would either clone it to make a Metroid army or use it to threaten the galaxy, which is where good old Samus Aran comes in to stop him. Over the course of the game, it could be implied that Silex's mere existence isn't thanks to Samus herself. If you've seen my Silex Theory video, you'll know what I'm talking about. It's also a nice little parallel between Samus and Dark Samus. Silex expresses his deep hatred for the Federation, done through visual storytelling and sometimes dialogue. He could destroy Federation equipment or even kill Federation soldiers. Not only that, it's here that Silex would imply that he hates Samus most of all for causing him so much misery and torment. Now, to those who might not be following what I am implying, I speculate that Silex could be the result of the Galactic Federation's attempts to make their own version of Samus, much like the Space Pirates, only they failed. Picture this. Due to Samus working very closely with the Galactic Federation and seemingly never fails, they wish to make their own version of her, in the sense that they could replicate her suit, morphing abilities, and almost limitless supply of weapons. Silex is the first successful replication of Samus, which wouldn't have been easy to do given the complexity of Samus' suit and technology. However, Silex then escapes with the technology that he was forcibly trained to work with and with the ship that he would have used. This perfectly sets up Silex to be one of the characters that we feel sympathetic towards. His whole life at the moment is to be an imitation of the galaxy's savior, and he didn't want that. So he seeks out power in an attempt to bring down the Galactic Federation and to have personal vengeance on the person who caused him all of his suffering, Samus Aran. However, none of this matters without proper execution. With that, we come to gameplay itself. How would Metroid Prime 4 play? Will it be like the rest of the Prime series, particularly Prime 1, or be almost completely different? Well, if you played the Metroid Prime series so far, then you kind of know what to expect. In fact, Nintendo themselves have said that the game is going to be more inspired by the first Metroid Prime, as opposed to the other two games. But let me put a little twist on that. The control should be like that of 2016's Doom. Doom? That's a bit out of left field, isn't it? Well, yeah, but it's genius. One of the many criticisms of the original two Prime games were the stiff, almost tank-like controls. Metroid Prime 3 remedied this by implementing motion controls to the series, but a lot of people don't like motion controls, so what do? Find a happy medium where you have the controls of the first games, but the accuracy and user-friendly approach of the third. Doom is the perfect model to base this on. Doom 2016 itself was clearly inspired by Metroid in how it handled secrets and some of the level design. The game felt like a fast-paced Metroid Prime to me, but it wasn't just a coincidence. There's a straight-up Mother Brain reference in Doom, so maybe Metroid can return a favor by being inspired by Doom's control scheme, which is fantastic in and of itself. Now, are we gonna see new upgrades? Definitely. Are there going to be many of them? There will likely only be one or two new upgrades, but the rest will be your traditional missiles, morph ball, bombs, varia, and possibly gravity suits. It's the beams that may change, but I won't get my hopes up. They will likely be the main three, Wave, Ice, and Plasma. So what could the new upgrades be? Well, given how the main antagonist is very much associated with the Galactic Federation, why not something in terms of the visor? It could pick up signs of Galactic Federation technology, or something cooler, something to do with your ship in terms of combat. Stick with me here, I think this is pretty cool. What if one of the fights with Silex is a space battle? Think about it, both Silex and Samus use gunships, both are shown to use them a lot, and both are geared towards combat. Why shouldn't there be a boss fight with Silex that doesn't involve both of your gunships? Probably budget and that I'm getting ahead of myself. Alright, we're nearing the end and I fancy talking about something that I don't want to see. Ridley. I do not want to see Ridley in this game. I won't be angry or annoyed if he is, but I feel like it'd be a wasted opportunity. Now, the Space Pirates should be in the game, as usual, but under the management of a different leader, Weevil. Who is Weevil, you ask? Another bounty hunter from Prime Hunters, who turns out to be a Space Pirate that Samus fought years ago. He should also be in the game to serve as a minor boss, much like how the Space Pirates are shown in other games. How his battles could work is that you are fighting Weevil, and after a certain amount of damage, he retreats, turning into his turret form, oh yeah, he can do that by the way, and he shoots you from a distance while Space Pirate reinforcements drop in. Once you deal with those, he comes back and the battle continues. When you beat him, however, he escapes by distracting Samus with a more important matter, like having her save animals or blow up something vital nearby. I have something very specific in terms of what they could do with Weevil, but that would take way too long to explore, enough for an entirely different video. However, I will give a little tease. Ridley shouldn't be forgotten. When you scan through pirate lore, it mentions the events of the previous games and how Ridley is somehow recovering from his injuries, but is still in too weak of a state to even run the organization, so Weevil takes over. Hence we get a little Starscream and Megatron similarity. Once Megatron is out or unable to rule as leader, Starscream swoops in to claim the title, but we all know what happens when Megatron returns and sees that his faction is ruled by someone else. And that is what I think may happen with Metroid Prime 4 in terms of gameplay and story. By god, this took a while to make. Thanks for sticking through this video, this one took an unexpected amount of time to do. But I had fun doing it anyway. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope that I didn't go too far with some of my ideas. I could have gone further, eh? I am that Metroid guy, and I will see you in the next mission. Bye bye.